If we go back to young years, then these lean PCOS patients, like their counterparts, the classical PCOS patients, are characterized by high androgen, high male hormone levels. Now, in everybody, woman or man, androgen levels decline with advancing age. They also decline in PCOS patients. And they decline usually slowly, with those declines accelerating after age 35 to 38, certainly after age 40. Now, PCOS patients, besides being characterized by high androgen levels, are also characterized by high AMH levels. AMH stands for anti-Müllerian hormone levels. And usually, as women get older, AMH levels and androgen levels drop kind of in parallel. But in a few years ago, one of our physicians, Dr. Vitaly Kushner, did a study where he was looking at how indeed these dynamics of AMH and androgens evolve as women get older. In other words, PCOS is not a stable condition that stays the same between age 20 and age 45. And the literature was aware of that, but had never really defined it. So what Dr. Kushner did is he followed patients through different age groups to see what is happening to PCOS patients as they get older. And to our big surprise, what we found, at least in our patient population, was that CHR, which is a center of last resort, so patients, infertile patients come to us after they usually have failed elsewhere many times over, we did not see many classical PCOS patients. Almost all of the PCOS patients that we saw were lean PCOS patients. And that got us interested in studying this group, and we asked ourselves, why is it that we see only these lean PCOS patients? And as we started concentrating on these lean patients, a very unique picture arose.